Joining us now to discuss, Republican Congressman Dan Meuser from Pennsylvania. Congressman, thank you for speaking with us this morning. Now, there are calls for Governor Wolf to reopen the state's battered economy and more quickly and broadly. You represent the 9th District in the eastern central part of the state. Would you like to see it happen in your region?
Yeah, again, we always have to follow the data, right? So-called follow the science. On the same note, there are parts of our Commonwealth that are far more safe and far less cases than in other areas, such as the Southeast and the Philadelphia area. So yes, definitely we need to be innovative. We need to be smart. We need to mandate a high level of safety standards for the businesses that can open up. And in fact, I strongly recommend that state associations or industry associations should write their own safety standards, because these are things we're gonna need moving forward. We need a safe working environment now, over the summer and into the fall, and we need to work on that now so as we get better at it over time. But yeah, I'm all for a safe working environment and opening up our economy in a staged approach, absolutely.
Congressman, I want to ask you specifically, going in on that point, what is the plan to reopen the Commonwealth's economy? Does it start with certain businesses that can open? You see parts of coastal states that are having some of their beaches open. Obviously, that's not in Pennsylvania, but what are some of the places that some of those residents in Pennsylvania could see open?
Well, it started with essential, and then in the Commonwealth, our governor went to a life-sustaining definition, which caused some confusion that we did our best to manage through, but we had the highest level of unemployment claims of any state. So what we need to do is we need to get our economy on track, and to any business that can open safely and maintain safe working standards and distances and social distances and workplace distances and minimal contact to no contact should be able to open. And again, you know, what the president's guidelines and the president and the vice president really set up like an air traffic control, right? Giving the states and the governors the autonomy to be innovative, to be creative based upon what the demands of their states are and what the data says. So what we need is uniform safety standards. It shouldn't matter what product you make or service you provide, as long as you can maintain a safe workplace for the workers, post what those standards are, and have people feel comfortable coming to work, we should be able to work. And in more hotspots, we should have inspections and a more stringent approach. But it needs to be done. It can be done safely. It is not mutually exclusive, a safe working environment versus not working at all.
Yeah, we know a lot of small businesses have been greatly impacted during this time. The Paycheck Protection Program President Trump signed into law will allow $484 billion to replenish that aid program for small businesses. How's the program benefited people in your district?
It saved many, many small businesses. The program has worked absolutely remarkably well. I mean, we got to keep in mind, within a 12-day period, $350 billion was put out in loans in the first tranche. That's how many loans the SBA normally puts out in a 12-year period. So now we have the second tranche going out, and some of the metrics and some of the results are even better here. I mean, this is a government program where the results and the intent of the law actually were the same, to save small businesses, to keep people retained within those businesses, and to minimize unemployment. I mean, granted, unemployment is way up, but economists estimates are that there'd be 20 million more, 25 million more unemployed if it weren't for this program. And the average has been loan has been about $225,000, with over 7% under $150,000. And the metrics showing in this next tranche, $310 billion. That the loan amounts on average are about $100,000. So there'll be more loans going out to more small businesses, and more small businesses saved. So it's really been outstanding.
All right. Well, we wish you and the rest of your state luck during this reopening process. We know it is a process, and we hope it's done safely. Republican Congressman Dan Meuser from Pennsylvania. Congressman, thanks so much.
Thank you.